Hello, my name is Mike. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to map categories in supplier catalogs to their corresponding categories. I'll begin by navigating to the catalog's work area. The Tasks panel lists all of the catalog management tasks that you can perform. I'll select the Manage Supplier Content Map Sets task. I'll create a map set. The Procurement Business Unit is selected for us. I'll enter a map set name and description. I'll also set this map set as a default for the procurement BU. And OK the confirmation message. Because we selected this map set as the default for the procurement BU, notice that there's a check mark in the default for procurement column. I'll create a category map for this map set. The desktop integration tool is a prerequisite for creating a category map. You can install it using the Download Desktop Integration Installer link in the Tools section of the Navigator. I'll select the Category Map and then create the map. I have to sign in using the same credentials I used to sign into the application. After I sign in, the mapping file spreadsheet appears. The external category column corresponds to the category names from the supplier. In this case, I'll enter A4 size printer paper. Notice that when you click in or tab to the key field, it's automatically populated. The internal category column corresponds to the categories available in your Oracle Procurement Cloud implementation. I'll double-click in this cell and select Office Supplies as the internal category. This completes adding one row. I'll add three more items to the category map. To insert a new row, I'll select the next row, right-click, and select Insert. This is the same as inserting a row in Excel. I've finished entering my categories, so I'll upload the mappings now. I'll accept the default settings for the upload. The status column shows that the mapping data was uploaded successfully. Now, here's how to delete an entry from the four entries we created. To delete, I need to download the data first. After the download is complete, the status column is blank. To do this, I'll double-click in the Mark for Deletion column. Note that a bullet item appears in the Mark for Deletion column. And then I'll upload. The row is deleted. I'll close the spreadsheet. Note that you can save the spreadsheet to your local desktop. For now, I won't save the spreadsheet. I'll edit the map set we just created, then add an entry to the map set. Let's see what happens if I add a duplicate entry. In this case, I'll enter A5 size copier paper, which is the same as the previous row. When I click into the internal category name field, it attempts to validate the external category. The insert fails because the row is a duplicate entry. The status viewer shows the details of the failure. I'll correct the external category name and click Upload again. The rows inserted successfully. And that's it. Thanks for watching.